Good to see you. Thanks so much for joining us. I want to get to that relief bill in just one second, but first I have to ask you, President Trump held a meeting on Friday in which he reportedly discussed with his disgraced former National Security Advisor, Michael Flynn, this deranged idea to declare martial law to force new elections in states that Biden won. They also have discussed appointing conspiracy theorist Sidney Powell as a special counsel to investigate her baseless claims of election fraud, and also issuing an executive order to seize voting machines. This is, needless to say, quite alarming and scary to a lot of people. What's your response? What will Senate Republicans do to make sure none of this madness happens?
Well, it's not going to happen. That's going nowhere. And I understand the president is casting about, trying to find some way to have a different result than the one that was delivered by the American people. But it's really sad in a lot of respects and embarrassing, because the president could right now be writing the last chapter of this administration with a victory lap with regards to the vaccine. After all, he pushed aggressively to get the vaccine developed and distributed. That's happening on a quick time frame. He could be going out championing this extraordinary success, and instead, he's leaving Washington with a whole series of conspiracy theories and things that are so nutty and loopy that people are shaking their head wondering what in the world has gotten into this man. And I think that's unfortunate, because he has more accomplishments than this last chapter suggests he's going to be known for.
I know you're eager to talk about the stimulus negotiations. It seems like there was a major breakthrough last night. Do you believe there is going to be a deal today?
Well, I believe there's going to be a deal. There are always sticking points, but the big one was resolved last night very late. And over the past, if you know, several weeks, there's been a lot of work done. Of course, it should have happened a long time ago. But, you know, we got a group together about 4 weeks ago that sat down and said, hey, we've got to find a way to get some progress here, for Republicans, for Democrats. We met time and time and time again. We came up with a $900 billion roughly proposal. That was picked up by leadership on both sides, and they're working on some additional points. But I think it's going to get done. It'll get done before Christmas.
One of the major sticking points has been the size of the direct payments to Americans. President Trump weighed in last night, tweeting that Congress should send more money. Where does that stand? Is it still, do you think, going to be at about $600 per individual?
Yeah, it's going to be $600, and it would be nice to be even more than that. But I think there's a recognition on the part of those of us that worked on this this deal that our highest priority is to get people who are worried about keeping their job. And so getting, if you will, help to small business is critical. Helping people that are unemployed, have extension of unemployment benefits, also housing support. And then, of course, the cost of vaccine distribution needs to be covered. We want to keep airlines flying, buses going, transit systems going. All these things are very, very high priority. So the check is going to be roughly $600 a person, and that will help, although I know people would like it to be a larger number.
Let's go to the massive